Hello and welcome to KCM Light, the KCM Light carol service today. We're really glad that you could join us. We've got lots of carols for you to sing today, interspersed with some of the traditional Christmas readings and a few other things thrown in as well. I'm sure you're going to enjoy our service today. We're going to begin though by focusing here on the one about whom it is all about, on Jesus. And we're going to use some liturgy as we come today to the fourth Sunday of Advent. We're going to use that liturgy just to focus us as we begin by lighting the fourth Advent candle on the wreath. Please join in with the words on the screen as indicated. Let us remember the glorious birth.
Glory to God in the highest.
God in his majesty came down to earth.
Glory to God in the highest.
To Mary the Virgin came the Spirit of life.
Glory to God in the highest.
She conceived and gave birth to Jesus, the Christ.
Glory to God in the highest.
Jesus, you are the glory of eternity, who now shines among us. Son of the High King of the universe, splendor of the Father, the morning star, Prince of Peace, wonderful Counselor, Light of the world.
This Christmas time, may we welcome you as the dawn, dispelling our darkness, and may the presence of the one who is the true light radiate in our hearts and illumine our way. Amen.
And amen. We're going to start by whisking you off for our first carol to King's College, Cambridge. So we invite you, wherever you may be, you can stay seated on your settee or you can stand up if you like. And let's join together in singing, Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Oh, reading is taken from Isaiah 9, verses 1 to 2 and 6 to 7. Nevertheless, there'll be no more gloom for those who are in distress. In the past, he humbled the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, but in the future, he will honour Galilee of the nations by the way of the sea beyond the Jordan. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. And the second reading is from Micah 5, verses 2 to 4. But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times. Therefore, Israel will be abandoned until the time when she who is in labor bears a son, and the rest of his brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth.
Deep and dreamlessly, the
be missing your Christmas chuckle in the carol service, so it's time once again for Chuck It in the Bucket! Hope you joined in with that at home. So let's see what we've got today. Here's the first one. Why did Mary and Joseph have to travel to Bethlehem?
I don't know. Why did Mary and Joseph have to travel to Bethlehem?
Because they couldn't book a home delivery. Oh, that's a good one. Let's have the next one then, shall we? Here we go. Another one to make you chuckle. Why wouldn't the school nativity be shown online?
I don't know. Why couldn't the school nativity be shown online?
Because there was no Zoom at the inn. Very good. Very topical joke there. And here we go. The third one for today. Why were Mary and Joseph late getting to Bethlehem?
I don't know. Why were Mary and Joseph late getting to Bethlehem?
Because all Virgin flights were cancelled. Very good. Well, do you fancy one more, seeing as it's nearly Christmas? Shall we give them one more, Tim?
Why not?
Let's do it then. Final one for today. Why won't Santa lose any presents this year?
I don't know. Why won't Santa lose any presents this year?
Because he's signed up to Second Trace. Oh dear me. Hopefully we'll have some more of those for you next time. Well, we're going to have what is many people's favourite carol next, Silent Night, and it's going to be produced by the KCM Worship Band. So we hope you enjoy this, and thanks to Andrew for producing and putting this together. And then after that, Sue's going to bring us our second reading.
Holy night, oh. Hello, Church. It's really sad that we can't all be together during this Christmas period, but I do hope and pray that God will be with you and your family. The reading are taken from Luke chapter 1 and chapter 2, beginning at verse 26. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favoured. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favour with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she who is said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her. And then from chapter 2, beginning at verse 1. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, Sue, for reading for us. Now, the Humphreys production team have been very busy again, and a real thank you to Karen and Gareth for all the work they've been doing. And they've produced something we're just going to watch now. In the style of a 1930s silent movie, we have The Silent Nativity. Hope, and I'm sure you will enjoy this. And then after that, we have another reading and a carol before Beth Powney, one of our church members and our regional minister, leads us in our prayer time in this carol service.
This reading is taken from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20, entitled The Birth of Jesus. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and laying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Amen.
Noel, 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 born
come to pray, I'd like to share a couple of verses from the end of Luke chapter 1. It says this in verses 78 to 79. Because of God's tender mercy, the morning light from heaven is about to break upon us, to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide us to the path of peace. Here we have Zechariah bringing his prophecy of hope following the birth of John the Baptist. And he ends this prophecy with proclaiming that because of God's love, the light from heaven is coming, that is Jesus, whose coming we celebrate at Christmas. And so as we come to pray together, I'd like us to use the last part of this passage as our response after each section that I lead us in. The response being, bring light to those who sit in darkness and guide them in the path of peace. So let's join together in prayer. Heavenly Father, as we come to you in prayer, we thank you for being our constant presence in a challenging year. When all around has been shifting sand, we know that you actually are our rock and our constant guardian. Even when we have not felt you near, you have been near, for you promise to never leave us or forsake us. But still we pray, bring light to those who sit in darkness and guide them to the path of peace. For those for whom the journey of this year has been one long experience of loss, loss of loved ones, loss of livelihood, loss of choices, and a sense, a loss of freedom, where darkness has been greater than presence of light, we pray, bring light to those who sit in darkness and guide them to the path of peace. Lord, we thank you for those who have worked sacrificially on our behalf, the care workers, the NHS staff and chaplains, the local GPs, the vaccine researchers, the bin men, the postal service, the delivery drivers, the supermarket assistants. For each of these people who are still working hard, we thank you, Lord God, and we pray that you would bring light to those who sit in darkness and guide them to a path of peace. We pray for our government, those to whom we have given elected power, those who serve as MPs and councillors, we thank you, Lord. For those who have discussed, debated and researched on our behalf to seek to steer us through uncharted waters, we ask you to bring light to those who sit in darkness and guide them to the path of peace. As we move towards celebrating your birth, Lord Jesus, at Christmas, you, the coming of the light of the world, we know that we can face the unknowns of 2021 with you. For our friends and family, our country and the whole world are in your hands. And so, Lord Jesus, by the power of your Holy Spirit, continue to bring light to those who sit in darkness and guide them to the path of peace. Amen.
Well, we're going to sing another carol again. It came upon a midnight clear to a slightly different tune, an alternative tune, which is really beautiful. And then after that, we've got a real treat for you, because Sarah and Joe, our ex-Salvation Army girls, are going to give us a timbrels display, which is something that was always very much enjoyed in our carol service. So I'm sure you'll enjoy that. And then after that, another reading and a carol.
reading is from Matthew chapter 2, beginning at verse 1. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Thank you.
roses are red, violets are blue. Some poems rhyme, but this one doesn't. I've never been much of a poet, to tell you the truth, although I do admire poets and lyricists for the way that they work the English language so beautifully. I don't know if you've heard of a 19th century English poet by the name of Christina Rossetti. Maybe a few of you have. But even if you haven't heard of her, you will definitely know her most famous poem, set to music by Gustav Holst, that has become a very well-known carol. Here's how it goes. In the bleak midwinter, frosty wind made moan, earth stood hard as iron, water like a stone. But can you remember the next line? Snow had fallen, snow on snow, snow on snow. So what do you think happened there then? Did Christina's creative juices just dry up? Did she have a poetic predicament? Snow had fallen, snow on snow, snow on snow. 5 times she uses the word snow. Maybe my roses are red, violets are blue poem wasn't so bad after all. But actually, if you stop to think about it for a moment, it's a line that actually says quite a lot. Snow falling, snow on snow, snow on snow. It's a way of describing a situation that was bleak, that was grim. It was winter where things were piling up one thing on top of another to make it a really difficult situation. Actually, that line, snow was falling, snow on snow, snow on snow, well, it could well have been written for the year 2020, couldn't it? It's been a year in which it seems everything has just piled on top of each other, one thing after another, crisis after crisis, snow on snow on snow. We've had this world pandemic, COVID-19, that has brought illness, death and misery to so many. It's affected our economy, with businesses having to close and people losing their jobs and their income. We've had to endure restrictions that have limited and prevented us seeing our family and friends. And as a church, restrictions have meant that for the most part of the year, we've not been able to gather together to worship in the way that we've been used to. Who'd have thought when all this began earlier in the year that we'd be having to have our carol service online? And on top of that, we've all had our own personal difficulties and crises that we've all had to deal with. It's been a difficult year, hasn't it? In the poetic words of Christina Rossetti, it's been like a bleak winter time, snow on snow on snow. So where is God in times like these? Well, the message of Christmas is that in the midst of difficult, traumatic and trying times, God came in the person of his Son. Just think for a moment how things were when Jesus came to this earth. On the national scene, Israel was subject to the restrictions that Roman occupation brought to their land. It was a bleak and miserable time with no end in sight. The nation had also endured silence from heaven for a period of about 400 years with all the doubt and questions and confusion that that brought. And then just think about the nativity story itself. For far from being the Disney-like version that is so often portrayed, there is rejection and pain, there's struggle and confusion as Mary experiences misunderstanding and the pain of rejection, initially from Joseph, but most certainly after that from her family and community when her pregnancy begins to show. Think of how Mary and Joseph are forced to make a 70-mile journey on foot whilst Mary is heavily pregnant. And then when they get there, there's nowhere to stay, as it seems none of Joseph's relatives were prepared to put them up, maybe due to the scandal of her pregnancy. So Mary ends up having to give birth in unhygienic, bleak conditions, and then ends up becoming a refugee in Egypt along with her baby and husband-to-be. Snow on snow on snow. It was bleak and it was difficult. And yet these were the conditions in which Christ came to our world. The true reality of the Nativity story is something that we need to hear afresh at this time. In the midst of confusion, trauma, and the difficulties of life, God is present and waiting to be birthed into our suffering and our mess. And Christmas shows us that God is willing to get involved in the messy, mixed up affairs of life in which people find themselves. You see, he's not a white gloved God who is way out there on the edge of the universe, hesitating to get his strong right arm dirty in the yuck of our lives. He's not a God of the wild blue yonder, waiting for us to pour bleach over our lives and situations before he will come to our aid. Whether we feel like we've got it together or not, God is the one who delights to come to his people in the chaos, the mess, and confusion that they find themselves in order to raise them back up again. The God of all grace. He's the God who allows weeping to endure for a night, but sees to it that joy comes in the morning. I wonder today, do you know this God? At Christmas, God gave himself in Jesus so that you and I might know him and the peace and the joy that he brings, even when the trials and difficulties of life are piling up. He can bring the peace and the joy that we so long for and crave. Snow on snow on snow and snow. That's what life is like sometimes, isn't it? But at Christmas, God comes into the midst of those situations and gives himself to you and I. So, what can we give him then? Well, that was a question that Christina Rossetti asked at the end of her poem. I'm sure you recall the words. What can I give him? Poor as I am. If I were a shepherd, I would bring a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would do my part. Yet what I can, I give him. Give him my heart. Why not give him your heart today? Maybe for the first time, or maybe afresh, and you will know the peace of God this Christmas time.
In the bleak midwinter, frosty wind made moan, earth stood hard as I. Water like a stone. Snow had fallen, snow on snow, snow on snow. In the bleak midwinter long ago, our God him cast. Hold him, nor earth sustain. bleak midwinter, a staple place sufficed. For the Lord God Almighty, Jesus Christ.
Well, we do thank you for joining us today. It's been great to be able to come into your homes, and we do hope that you've enjoyed singing along all the carols and all the other things that we've done in today's service. We do want to let you know that if you're looking for just a service that you could watch maybe on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day, there is a short Mildenhall Joint Church's Christmas service that will be available on YouTube from the 23rd of December. Please just follow the link in the weekly notices, or if you just want to go into YouTube and type in Mildenhall Joint Church's Christmas service, there's just a short service that you could watch maybe on Christmas Day or Christmas Eve if you would like. We're going to come to our last carol now, and we're going to go out with a great joyful carol arranged by Chris Tomlin. Joy, unspeakable joy, joy to the world. And it's going to be done by the KCM Worship Band. And a big thanks to Andrew West for all the work that he's done in producing this. Please enjoy and sing along together.
To the world, the Lord is come. receive a king. Let every heart declare him rule, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and
joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest and remain upon you this Christmas time and always. Amen. Really do hope that even though it may be a bit of a different Christmas, that you really have an enjoyable and a good time over Christmas. May you know the Lord's peace. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Bye bye.